Praise the Lord. Very good morning to you, good brothers and good sisters.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Time to wake you up. Father, let's have the joke of the day.
Yeah. Again, the joke about the clergy today.
Okay.
This is not to put down anybody. It is only the jokes that I found in some books.
Wonderful.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the book is that jokes about the Jesuits. From that book I got it. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Now, well, there was a Franciscan and a Jesuit. They were very good friends.
Okay.
They are friends because, well, as it is said, the birds of a feather flock together.
Flock together. Yes.
They were good friends because both of them were chain smokers.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh.
Very good smokers, we can say. Even they cannot take bath without smoking, and while taking shower they would smoke, because the shower will be on, the cigarette will be in the hand of smoking. So that kind of smokers. So, but they suffered as religious, you know, because they were not praying for a very long time, because
correct,
they could not
sit for a long time
without smoking.
Cigarette, yes.
Okay. Now they wanted to seek the permission from the superior. Right. Whether they could smoke while praying.
Yeah.
Okay. A few days passed, both of them had met their major superiors.
Correct.
And the Franciscan went with his face down when he met the Jesuit.
Yeah.
They asked, why your face is down? What happened? You met your superior and what is the outcome? He said, I asked my superior whether I can smoke while praying. And superior said, no, at least while praying you cannot smoke. You should be very serious about your prayer.
Yes.
So I did not get the permission. But he said, you look very happy, cheerful. What happened? Did you get the permission from your superior?
He's asking the Jesuit.
Franciscan is asking the Jesuit. He said, yes, I got the permission. And what did you ask? I did not ask the way you asked. I asked it this way. I asked my superior, can I pray while smoking? And he said, yes, you can pray anytime, anywhere. Yeah, so I got the permission.
Yeah. Wow. too good. Can I pray while smoking?
Yes.
Wonderful.
It depends now, how you ask the question.
And now, no, better tell the audience, better not ask these questions. Other they learn from us and they'll start asking.
Yeah.
Okay, my dear brothers and sisters, a very good morning and up and about. Today's question is this, Father. John 15:13. Greater love has no man than this, that he lay down his life for his friend.
Yeah.
Father, very powerful statement.
Yeah.
Where a friend is ready to lay down his life, give us an insight into how we can follow this.
Yeah. Now, if you understand this context of the passage, Jesus is at the Last Supper.
Yes.
The last moment of his life, so painful moment, at a graceful moment for Jesus, being with his apostles whom he had chosen. At the Last Supper, he had washed the feet of his apostles. Now he's giving the exhortation, what they have to do.
Correct.
They have to follow what Jesus has done for them.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, when Jesus says, there is no greater love a man can have than to lay down his life for his friends, he says. Okay?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Now, laying down one's life, very, very important.
Correct. Of course.
The friendship is valid and remains true and remains as friends as long as we give something. Of course, when we are friends, we are good in giving the gifts.
Yes.
Because when you give the gift, if I want back, I can buy it again.
Exactly.
The things we can bring back, okay?
Right.
But once you lay down your life, there is nothing left. That is the ultimate thing a person can give to his friend.
Correct.
That is what Jesus says. When you give something to somebody, don't withhold anything for yourself. Do not think of having something back for you. Give yourself totally, your life, where there is nothing to seek for, because your life is not there to ask for again.
Yes.
So that is the love Jesus is saying, that lay down your life.
Correct.
And Jesus does not speak in an empty way.
Right.
Because he himself, he knows, is that he's preparing himself for that, right, and gives that commandment to them.
Yes.
So Jesus is preparing his apostles for what he's going through.
Correct.
He's going to die now for the sake of the people.
Yes.
And what kind of people? It's not just his friends, not the people, those who did good for him.
Right.
Jesus is going to die for the people who have done evil for him. Jesus is going to die for the forgiveness of our sins.
Exactly.
For the well-being of others, he's going to lay down his life.
Right. Exactly.
And that is what Jesus says, lay down your life for another person. So in that you express the true love.
Amen.
There is a incident that is narrated.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? A novice in the novitiate.
Right.
He was asking the novice master that he wants to live and go.
Okay.
The novice master said, why you want to live and go? No, you know, I had my friend during my school days. Now she has returned to me that if I don't return back, she's going to commit suicide.
Oh.
So I don't want to become responsible for her death.
Right.
Therefore, our love was very deep. We were truly loving each other. And the novice master tried to ask him a lot of questions, whether that love is true. Novice master said, no, it is not. It is just attraction. Not to know. It is really true love. And the novice master said, let us have a test of that love.
Yeah.
Okay. And he whispered something in his ears and said, okay, call those people.
Yes.
So the family members came. And when they came, this novice had died. His body was kept in the coffin and kept in the church.
Just an act of doing it.
Okay. So, put in the coffin and it was kept on the church for prayers. And all of the novices, everybody was in the mood of prayer when the family arrived.
Right.
When they came and they saw, they were surprised. And this girl was in bitter tears and all the family members were crying. And the novice master said, he died yesterday.
Okay.
Of a sudden, we do not know the cause of death. Of course, those days we could not identify the heart attack or what. Maybe heart attack.
Yes.
Okay, he died. Now, there is one condition. There is a possibility to bring him back to life.
Right.
Okay. But in turn, you people should have truly loved him, isn't it? Even this friend of him for whose sake he was ready to leave the seminary and go back.
Correct.
Now, the condition is this. If any one of you is ready to lay down your life for this person, if any one of you is ready to die,
yes,
that your life will go into him and he will come back to life.
Wow.
And the girl said, I can find somebody else. So she was the first one to live and go.
My God.
Okay. Huh. And the noise master woke him up and said, see, she can find somebody else when you die. And what kind of love you are speaking about? But Jesus laid down his life without counting the cost.
Amen.
So that is the love we are called to share. True friendship is being ready to die for another. But today we see a lot of people, okay? They say that I love.
Yeah.
And in the pursuit of love, if you see the simple thing, you see the family members, the children today, the young boys and girls, okay, they are ready to reject the parents and go after somebody whom they say that I am ready to, I love that person and that person is everything for me.
Correct.
So they leave the parents without realizing that parents had died for them in order to give birth. The mother has died for that child. You know, in giving birth to a child, the mother dies and comes back to life.
Correct.
Nobody knows the pain that mother goes through.
Oh my God, yes.
And to bring that child up, the parents really die. They sacrifice so much for the sake of the children.
Correct, correct.
But when they are grown up, because they found somebody, the children say that we don't care our parents. That is my true love, that I am ready to leave my parents in order to follow that person.
Very sad.
It is stupidity.
Really,
in today's world, first I exhort the youth of today. Your parents have died for you in bringing you into life.
Yeah.
What you are today, it is because of your parents, because of their sacrifice, because of their death. They may not have died physically.
Yes.
That physical death, even they would say that if I would have died, it would have been better, they say.
Correct.
Why am I alive to see this day?
Yes.
You do not know with what pain they are saying it.
Amen.
Okay?
Yes.
Because they have died several times in order to bring you up. The mistakes that you've done, to forgive you, to stand by you when you are sick, to spend the sleepless night.
Correct.
And all the sacrifices they have made to make you happy.
Exactly.
So my dear brothers and sisters, my dear young people, remember the love of your parents. And if you meditate on that, we are able to understand the love of Jesus Christ who died on the cross to free us from sin and to lead us to God, to make us the true children of God.
Amen.
Yeah.
Father, beautifully, very beautifully explained. Let us pray that everybody comes to the same line as Jesus taught us. See, Jesus never simply taught us.
Yeah.
He did it with an example.
Everything he taught with example.
So this also,
he
gave his life for
us.
Let's pray.
God Almighty Father, we thank and praise you for the gift of life and for all the blessings that you shower upon us. We thank you for your Son Jesus Christ, who came into the world sacrificing the divinity. He lived like us as humans, undergoing all the trials, difficulties, problems of this human life. And finally, having lived for our redemption, he died on the cross, showing the extreme, the ultimate proof of his love for us. As we thank him, dear Lord, give us the grace to overcome our sinfulness, being obedient to him and to love each other just as Jesus has taught us, even to the point of dying for our brothers, our sisters, the people who are dear and near to us. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Have a lovely day. Go about loving your brothers and sisters.
Especially your parents.
Parents.
Wherever they are.
Yes.
May they be so happy with your love that they'll live for many, many more years.
Yes.
Just God bless to bless you. All
of us. Yeah. God bless you.
God bless you.